Another day, another controversy surrounding Jake Paul. There seems to be no single dull day in Jake Paul's fighting career, and the twists outdo themselves every time. So what's the latest among these? Let's take a look. There's perhaps not a single boxer out there who is willing to let Jake Paul off the hook. Ever since Jake and Logan stepped into the boxing world, they've received a lot of hate. Many professional boxers don't even consider the Paul brothers worthy opponents, and consider them a sham altogether. Some even take their participation as outright disrespect. However, in the latest course of events, Hasim Rahman Jr. has done the exact same thing. Hasim believes that Jake Paul fakes his fights. Hasim Rahman Jr. is a dynastic fighter, following in the footsteps of his father, who has been known for being notorious inside the ring. As such, Rahman becomes one of the most serious opponents that Jake has ever faced in his career. And quite ironically, Rahman is the one being extensively concerned about the fight and how it might unfold. Rahman has had a short career so far, and it seems like there's going to be a long way ahead for him. The same can be said for Jake Paul. However, many contest Jake's legitimacy as a fighter altogether.
First time he was very green, and it was like what I took away from it was like, okay, he's tough. He's not just gonna go away when you punch him, because some people, when they first get into boxing and you hit them one good time, they'll stop, or they'll find a way out. But I was like, okay, he's tough. He take a punch, keep coming. Okay.
And was recently, Rahman has also adopted the course that is typical for most of Jake's earlier competitors: a vicious media battle against his opponent. Rahman thinks that Jake Paul has so far been dishonest with his viewers when it comes to displaying a genuine fight with actual competition. This means that he's not considering Jake to be honest with him either. Rahman has already previously accused Jake of faking many of his fights. He believes that Jake Paul manipulates the outcome to appear almost as if he is the better man inside the ring and doesn't actually possess any meaningful skills as a boxer.
He's really using boxing and wants to call himself a boxer, but then give him all the MMA fighters all the big money. So you really using boxing to catapult the MMA. I really feel like he's stealing from boxing. So, you know what I'm saying? What type of shit is that? He's you pay the boxer less, literally half the amount of the lowest payment that you gave the MMA fighter. So he's a fraud to me. Everything he do is fraud. Just a big fraud, and I'm gonna expose him on August 6th.
As such, Rahman has most recently revealed how Jake added a secret clause to their own contract for the upcoming fight in order to systematically disadvantage Rahman. Rahman claims that the contract he has with Paul was designed in order to put him under pressure to lose weight vigorously. The contract actively states that Hasim Rahman will lose 25% of his purse for the fight for every pound that he is overweight. He thinks that, in the end of it all, he might just be left with a $5,000 takeaway, which is the minimum that was set.
Excuses
as you always talk about, oh, he's bigger than me. He's bigger than me. Oh, he's a heavyweight and all this and all that. That's cut, because we come in the cruiserweight. Thank you. But you keep calling me a heavyweight.
Why
you
keep calling me a heavyweight? Fan.
Why you keep calling me a heavyweight? Talking Muhammad heavyweight if you're not fighting me a heavyweight.
If this is 100% true, then this puts Rahman in a very compromised position, since he simply cannot risk losing his entire payout, especially after having seized it himself like he has in his fighting career. But at the same time, Rahman can't also risk losing weight in a hurry, since that would mean greatly compromising his strength and essentially damaging his career in the long run. He would definitely not want to become unhealthy and would also not want to get this fight for nothing, so he might just be suffering from a lot of confusion at the moment. It seems like Jake has been doing his homework on how to draft contracts just as much as he's been training for the actual fight itself. Hasim is a lot larger than Jake, and this was originally intended to bring him down in size before the fight happened. But considering that he's just 4 pounds over, it means that it will effectively take away all of his originally agreed payout. So it makes perfect sense why Hasim is currently calling Jake out and seems to be exceptionally angry with the aspiring fighter.
This man with one hand, and I promise you, he turned his back. He turned his back and ran from me. That's what's going on in his whole camp. That's all they do. Look, Rock, don't do this. Don't switch southpaw. Don't sit here and say you don't, because when I spar you, you do the same thing. It's always a handicap. And that's what I was trying to tell him. It's a handicap in here. Don't get
At the same time, Hasim has also alleged that Jake is afraid of him and will potentially do anything in his power to further deteriorate Hasim's position. Quite frankly, this is a very tricky situation for any third party to judge and pass a verdict. Since Hasim had the opinion to review the contract, why did he not object to this there? And it remains a mystery and might just alleviate a lot of the negative perceptions about Jake Paul that might emerge out of this proceeding. At the same time, it does put a question mark on how ethical Jake Paul's conduct in the boxing world is. A lot of people have already complained about how Jake Paul manipulates his fights to achieve a desired outcome. For example, many say that Jake Paul, despite all his victories, has only arranged for fights against fighters who are not professional boxers. But at the same time, he did fight Tyron Woodley, who happens to be a pretty decent former MMA fighter. Woodley stepped into boxing and was defeated by Jake twice consecutively. Even if he didn't know how to box the first time around, he was still expected to learn before his second chance against Jake. At the same time, Jake Paul has been trying to fight Tommy Fury for quite some time now, and their fight in December last year was all set to happen until Tommy backed out. We really can't blame Jake for not trying, since he was visibly entirely ready to fight Tommy.
Jake, Tommy, yeah. What's going on, son?
Listen, you need to stop ruining my friend, and let's get it on.
What's going on? Chill out.
In fact, he even made a bet against Tyson Fury regarding who would win the bout.
Wait for it. So this is what Tyson Fury just said in an interview. Check it.
I'm backing Tommy. I put my money where my mouth is. I've got 100 grand with anybody. I put it on Tommy and that's it. That's how I feel about it.
So guys, Tyson Fury, who made $40 million last year, is willing to bet $100K on his brother. Oh my God, we're shaky. Hey Tyson, you fucking put. You made $40 million. I know it wasn't as much as me, but let's up the ante. Let's bet $1 million on it, Tyson. $2 million, $3 million, however much you want to fucking bet, let's do it. Are you down? Make a deal. See, I could tell when someone's really not confident because these pussy motherfuckers, Twitter and internet, whoever's watching, they're in here. They're all on this Twitter app. They're scared. I could tell when they're scared. But me, I'm a cold motherfucker. I'll bet anyone, anytime, any place. Let's run it up.
Besides, many professional boxers did not have a very welcoming attitude towards Jake Paul. So it's not entirely fair for us to blame Jake for not having fought a professional thus far. As for the fight with Hasim Rahman, we can only wait to see how this develops and whether Jake steps up to refute Rahman's claims.
I'm a fan of Jake at the moment.
As far as the outcome of the fight is concerned, it seems like a pretty tough guess, but we do know that a lot of people are looking forward to seeing this happen. So that's all the time we had today, folks. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and do hit the bell icon on your way out. See you all next time.